Gary, my final question for you is about LinkedIn. We know that recruiters go to LinkedIn to check a candidate. LinkedIn is a living, breathing platform that you can change, you can update. You don't have to keep it the same for the last 10 years. So what tips do you have for job seekers to make their LinkedIn profile shine? And is it okay to change from time to time?
Yes. Matter of fact, so with LinkedIn, I like to say this has the potential to be like your sort of online portfolio. Mm-hmm. And when I say portfolio, you know, that typically, you know, is, you know, reserved for people that are in creative or like a design sort of thing. But no, this can apply to anyone. You're in finance or whatever. And, you know, the first and foremost is your profile photo. You know, is it something that is going to give the vibe that you were looking for?
Mm-hmm.
You know, take some time and look at it, you know, and make adjustments. It shouldn't just be that photo that you liked and then you cropped out that person and you still sort of see your hand, you know, over to the side. You know, go, you know, you don't necessarily have to go and, you know, get professional headshots. We have, you know, very high resolution phones in our pocket.
Mm-hmm.
You know, take some time, you know, make sure, you know, it's, you know, either the background's clean or it's in a, you know, a spot that, you know, can really highlight you.
Yeah.
You know, if you're going for a position where, you know, they tend to dress more formal, all right, you know, do that. You know, if it's more laid back, you know, maybe like, again, as I mentioned in a previous video, I have a marketing background. You know, those environments tend to be a little bit more relaxed. All right, boom. You know, so that's the big thing. You know, the next thing that, you know, that people overlook is that headline.
Yeah.
Because if you're reaching out to someone, and I know for experience, you know, when someone sends me an invite and I look at the, I'm not sure who they are, and I'm like, oh, all right, cool. And I look at the headline, like, all right, your headline should be like, what's your big offering? Yeah, who are you? What are you bringing to the table? Play around with that. Again, switch it up, you know, from time to time. And then, you know, yes, you have all of your work statements. And again, just like your resume, it should be action oriented. But here's the other thing. This is where I said it's like your portfolio.
Yeah.
How are you sharing things to the community? Mm-hmm. Like, you know, whether it's little sound bites of stuff that you learned, or maybe it's articles. Again, you know, this is going, especially if a recruiter or something is looking at your LinkedIn, trying to, you know, get a character gauge on who you are. That's a great way to show how you think.
Yeah.
So take advantage of those. I know there are so many others, but I want to keep it brief. Those are like the top ones that I think will make a big impact.
Yeah, and lately there's been on the LinkedIn profile that you can upload a picture using from your phone to tell more who you are and what you're offering. And the about section, you can tell about what's your offering. And I feel that personal branding, networking, content creation, there's all related with each other, and it's all happening in the LinkedIn world. So even if you have a job, you should constantly doing it. What we are doing now. And they're always saying that you need at least make 5 comments or 10 likes and make connections and build those relationships, because you never know what's going to happen in the future.
Yeah. Keep that updated. Yeah. Don't wait till you need a job to like scramble and whatnot. Yeah. There are settings where, you know, you can, you know, do things under the cover and it doesn't, you know, give the impression like, oh, such and such is looking for a job. No, if your profile is updated and you're consistently adding content, you're good to go.
So those are great tips, Gary. I really appreciate that. And I hope people will implement that in their job search. And with that, my interview with you comes to an end. I really enjoyed the conversation. It was very easy, very actionable items. And for the audience watching or listening, if you have any other tips in terms of LinkedIn, please leave comments below and tune in next time for another guest I'm preparing for you guys. So Gary, again, thank you very much and we'll be in touch.
Bye, everyone. Thank you. Bye, everyone.